What up, my dudes? It's Max from Papillon Effect. I think it's about time for another beer plays. Roll the theme music. Take a sip. Very refreshing. And today we are playing What Remains of Edith Finch. This is it's a game that's very true to my heart. I have a really fucked up family in a lot of ways. And it's kind of about that. It's about a family. It's not a long game. I'm gonna probably break this up into a few parts. I'm gonna break up the parts by beer, just so it's in smaller sections for people. I've been meaning to do that. Final Fantasy, I've been playing longer, but anyways, here's an experience for you, and I hope you enjoy it.
This isn't going to make sense to you, and I'm sorry about that. I'm just going to start at the beginning, with the house.
Okay.
My brother Milton disappeared when I was 4. It was like the house just swallowed him up. Someone had put up a chain link fence, but it looked like I wasn't the first person to hop it.
Yeah. Yeah, you're gonna notice, especially if you look down. This is gonna be a sad story. Sad story. Is there a run button? Oh, that's that. Let's zoom. It's another zoom. Okay.
I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms.
Anyone who's going back and watching this, because this is my second actual playthrough of anything, it's not Final Fantasy, or this is my second playthrough, yeah, Final Fantasy is my first playthrough. Our family being kind of like this, this is why I drink. That's why it's called Beer Plays.
Inside the mailbox were bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately.
Sorry, I'm still getting the controls down. I played this with PC controls, but now
I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral.
I play with the controller, so you don't hear the clapping if you were watching this for the first time, and this is your first video. Or if I fixed the keyboard controller at this point.
In her will, my mother left me a key, but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought that the mystery would be enough to bring me back.
There's multiple routes, by the way. I'm gonna take a specific route through the game, but, you know, just so you know, you can play this yourself and it'll be a little bit different. I like how calming and somber this is.
The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to.
Yeah. It It's so pretty. It's really pretty on my new PC. I mean, this is kind of why I sprung for it, man. I wanted to see, because, like, I played it.
The woods around the house have always been uncomfortably silent. As if they're about to say something, but never do.
I bought it so I could experience stuff like this. Because it didn't play well on my old PC. It still played it. I still beat it. But I'll try and keep a little more quiet on this playthrough. Just because this is kind of the game that you need to hear her story. Less of my punk ass. Let's be honest. Probably not going to be as loud and obnoxious as I normally am.
The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it. I asked Edie once about the dragon in the pond. She said it had killed her husband. I was 6. It seemed like an odd joke to me even then.
If you're really curious about this, I guess watch me play it first. If you're gonna play it yourself, play it yourself and don't watch this. I would say that first, Ralph, before we start this. But if you're gonna watch this first and then go and see, so at least you know everything that's going on. Then go and see, there's a gentleman named Joseph Anderson. And if you're gonna watch this, you really need to watch his review of it.
As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words.
I'll give some insight, but, he does it more justice. I know he's going to, because it's an actual thought-out review. He's what made me want to play this. But the reason I played through it...
Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house.
The reason I keep playing through it a few times, it's probably my third, is because of how it makes me feel. How it reminds me of my family in Oregon, even not my father's side per se, but my father and stuff.
I hoped the key might unlock the front door. It didn't. Looking in, I felt like the house itself had been waiting for me.
Wheelie bins that are completely fine after all these years. Orc Asylum.
The house felt like it had always been here. Even the swing set was older than my mother. Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11.
She's pretty small for someone who's pregnant, as well as widowed. I don't know how widowing would, unless getting fat, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean. Yeah, there's a beer in there. I get the screwdrivers, wrenches, saw a little bit. It's all these wedges, man. These chisels. The fuck would you... I mean, I... Well, actually, you know what? Never mind. I know. So take flooring out. Glued down flooring. Which I'm sure a fucking house like this would have.
For the first time in years.
Glued down flooring is a bitch to take out, by the way.
I felt like I was home.
It's a lot of wine bottles. Down for this place and all that fucking tuna over there. It's a cool stove. Is this a stove? It is a stove. Who stacks books on a stove? Guessing this is probably for decoration at this point. Is there another one? Oh yeah, okay, there's a proper. I'm gonna look through this. Like, I'm gonna try and experience it fresh. Keep a good look at it. Damn! This family's big, but I didn't know they needed that much fucking toast. Fort Saltwater Yeast Tasting Thailand. Oh, these are cookbooks. It's a cookbook! It's a cookbook!
But instead of a family, there were just memories of one.
Even one of those Brita water filters. Edith Finch. Died in 2010. Beloved brother of Edith. Just a heads up, anyway. Edith is the character you're playing. That little girl in this. Edie, who is the original Edith Finch, just so you know, just as a heads up. She's the matriarch. So, your mom is Dawn, Edith is you, and then your brother Louis is there. Pie? I don't know if that makes apple pie. Where's the eggs? Maybe that's just the crust. I don't know. I never did it too in depth. I just kind of scanned it. They've got a lot of fucking money, these people. Hey, I got a wallpaper like that. Sort of
the table was still a wreck from the night we left. It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture.
Oh shit. That's foreshadowing. Dude, they put so much detail in this game. Like that Joseph Anderson review. There's like two plot holes in this game, sort of. But they also could not be. Because, I mean, the mom gave the daughter the key. And just keep that in mind. I'm going to try and not spoil anything if you're watching this. Also, major plot hole. Where the fuck did they get the takeout Chinese from? Like, you have to ride a boat to get here. I think. Also, where do you get a fucking iPod from, huh? Well, no, 2010 was, I guess, like the late, like when the one character died. So, you know, they could have those at this point.
Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it. Like a smile with too many teeth.
Yeah, right. I was just thinking that it's messy as a motherfucker. Well, that's what happens when it's like generation after generation and we got millions of fucking books.
Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house after it sank.
Interesting. That's the original house, by the way. Right there. It'll tell it at some point, but I might as well just explain a little bit, because some of it you might not get. I got a lot of it, mainly only because I watched Joseph Anderson's review first, but I have a feeling that if I just was experiencing this, I wouldn't get a lot of shit first.
Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't too surprised when the key didn't fit.
Did you spit on it first?
Great-grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house.
Testing a theory. No. Okay. bugs. Hey, Papillon. Papillon effect. Sharp RD. Looks like they're already moving to begin with.
My mom wasn't much of an optimist, but she never stopped believing that my brother Milton was alive. A lot of things got left behind in the whirlwind of that last night.
Oh shit. Who the fuck? Okay.
Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library. After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes. Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947.
It's kind of like Mario Brothers or Super Mario 64. Everyone's sealed in a
painting. I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room.
That's the house under the water.
I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up.
The fuck did they drag out of here? Stage cover? Under the water? Oh. That's actually kind of fucked up now that I think about it. That's really fucked up. There's the grandpa. Some other shit. Whoever's the artist is really good. I'm sure there's several.
Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara.
Yeah, she's like a movie star for some kind of Jason movie. According to that picture.
Mom must have locked the third floor stairs on the night we left.
I hope that this cable... I'm paying more attention than I did last time, just to check and see like any little clues.
Barbara was a child star for 2 years, until America grew out of it. Edie's father Odin built the original house. The last time I was in Edith Senior's room, I was 10 and she was painting my portrait.
Yeah, I see. So there's something that you're gonna realize is like, so everyone who's dead, grandma made a mural for them. So this is the main plot hole, is like, after the grandmothers died, you know, who came back and put her place on there? The only person was the mom. And Joseph Anderson, in his channel, he pontificates. He's like, well, why would she do that? You know, that doesn't make no sense. Because she gave the key to Edie, our Edie, the one we're playing as. So I guess...
As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of.
Yeah, so it makes sense, I guess, if the mom kind of follows what her mom did. Or her grandma.
My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, Calvin.
And you're like, oh, well, so Edith Senior is the one that's making all these murals, but the key is given by Edith's mom, Edith Junior.
Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him.
Which is the first key to the secret passage. The first secret passage.
Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of.
I don't like the voice actor Edith doing making those noises. I'm trying to feel sad here. Don't be going.
From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me. Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan.
Oh, and, okay, hold on, let me get through this fucking door.
But I had no idea what was behind that door. Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead.
So yeah, we are effectively playing as Edith. But, as you see in the beginning part, there is a child with a cast reading a book, and that's the narration. So, we're there. This is us playing the mom. And, yeah, it goes down several rabbit holes since there.
I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole. Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage.
Oh, that's cute. I didn't see that last time I was here.
Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
Like Super Mario Brothers. Super Mario 64. She liked owls. Oh, her aunts all died! No. The gerbil died, the ants died, this fucking starfish died, that Papillon, that butterfly died. Fuck those guys. But still, like, everyone's fucking dying in this story.
I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
Yeah. Well, your first daughter dying. That makes sense. How would you handle it, you know?
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. My Halloween candy was all gone. Mom, can I come out now?
Sweetheart, it's late. Go to sleep.
Edith Finch, more like Sweetith Finch. Oh yeah, we eat the
gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it.
Why don't you eat the gerbil? You sleeping in there, right? This is why I stash food around places. It's like my greatest fear.
I thought about eating Christopher, but I held back.
Why? I mean, I guess swallowing a fish makes more sense than eating a gerbil. Or these ants, for that matter. I don't know, man. I would just throw a fucking fit. Oh, I know! There's some logs in here. Oh no, they're all gone. Damn it, that's why you don't flush.
I kept eating and eating.
That's how you throw up.
I ate a lot of things that night.
So, in the theory here, so Joseph Anderson's review, he's like, oh, the mistletoe is supposed to be poisonous, but it's not enough to kill you. But a big fan theory about this is that because she ate all that other shit, it wasn't that she ate the mistletoe necessarily, but it's that she made herself sick on lots of things, and she choked on her vomit. Because, by the way, everyone's
gonna... Then I heard chirping outside my window.
Yeah, everyone's gonna die, by the way. There's no character that you see besides the baby in the stomach that's reading the story. No one escapes this. This
it
is
was
a sad
a barn
story.
Swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. And suddenly, I was a cat.
Cat in the hat. And how's it go?
I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared.
Shit, chat, chapeau. In Spanish, he's a gato in a sombrero. Come here, motherfucker, I'm gonna eat you.
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
Seem a little stoned. Oh, the kitty's purring. What? Had several cats. Only occasionally do they make those jumps very easily. Usually most of the time they fall and it's really fucking funny.
I jumped and I almost got her.
Come here, motherfucker. Come here, come here. You're about to be dinner.
I could tell she was getting really tired.
Wait. Ooh. Is there a Nuka-Cola around? No? A lot of fogs. A lot of fog imagery. Yeah, this reminds me a lot about my family in Oregon. The fucked upness and the iconography.
Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird.
Come here, motherfucker. I'm stealthing my surprise. Watch this. I'm coming for you. I'm gonna get you. Come here, bitch.
I gobbled her up.
Ha ha!
Suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass.
Oh, yeah.
Rabbits.
Achievement, I gotta get them, two of them without missing. El Swoopo! Well, I guess I failed that fucking achievement. Well, I guess from the moment I catch the first one, maybe then I'll, maybe then. Okay, come here, bitch. Come here. I'm gonna get you. Yeah! Eat that motherfucker!
Looking up and seeing mine through my talons.
Gross. Fucking gross.
I swallowed him up and I didn't chew one bit.
Gross.
Then I
flew
off to find something bigger.
I'm guessing they don't. Something bigger? What's that? Oh, maybe I fucked it up. So I get two owls. Oh, cartoon as well. It's two rabbits.
A mama rabbit.
Coming at you. Coming at you. Yes!
She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating.
Gonna get the achievement.
And suddenly, I was a shark!
Makes sense. Oh, well, fuck up that achievement. That's unintentional comedy. Okay. Have it up.
I rolled off a cliff and into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever. Everything had changed. Now I was
hey,
a
Finch
monster
Fishing Company.
And I smelled people everywhere.
Oh shit. That must be where they make their money. In Seattle, Washington. No wonder it looks like Oregon. Wow. I also love this song. So that's where their money's from. They own a fishing company, and why they live where the fuck they live. I don't remember fishing companies having cars and shit. Knock over.
I was big. But I moved real quiet.
rusty. He's rich, his belly was rusty. His belly was rusty, razor.
What if you looked at those two 3D glasses if it would look 3D? That's fucked up. I've never been so drunk I've been in my shoulder singing stupid shit. Directly to the sea? How does that flush?
I got closer and closer. All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be, and we both know I will be delicious.
She has great handwriting for a kid.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
How? They had to have found the fucking body. Edie's fucking drunk. That's one thing you'll find out. Drunk. Drunk lady. Hey. There's cats? Where's your kitty? Oh, hey, there is your kitty. Hello, kitty gato. Oh, you're gonna run away from me. Fuck you. I don't wanna pet you anyway, you punk ass motherfucker, son of a bitch. Dirtbag. But he owes me money.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly.
Oh, hey, that was Molly. You'll see Molly again later. I didn't realize that. I wasn't alerted. I didn't wear headphones the first time I played this. I didn't realize the cat was there. Oh, I just realized. They got Dish! No wonder their reception sucks.
I spent a lot of time in Great Grandma Edie's room.
All the birds have names, and when they died, she just put a picture up of them. Oh, shit. Oh, and the snake, Bob. He's cool. I like Robert. He's an okay dude. There's, apparently my grandpa's bird, he had like a, it wasn't a finch. It was a cockatoo. Looked kind of like, this guy. No. Maybe more like this. I don't remember. Anyways, the bird died like several times, and my grandparents just, or not my grandparents, they didn't want my grandpa to, even though he taught it tricks. So
Edie knit me
be...
a new pair of gloves every year, just in time to replace the old ones.
It should seem obvious that the bird was dying because it didn't know the tricks anymore, but they kept replacing the bird with the exact same fucking type of bird that looked the same. Something I remembered.
Lewis died a week before we left, but Edie had already started to memorialize him.
Sure. Oh, those are expensive. And it's in pristine condition. Look how shiny it is. There's no dust on it at all. It's almost like no one... It's almost
her room
like,
is like a museum.
It's like people had been here. Almost. What you got?
For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune. And misfortune.
Oh, it was Norway. Yeah.
Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse, his wife Ingeborg, and their newborn son, Johan. On January 7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house, hoping to leave the curse behind.
That seems like that's a failure right off the bat.
But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea.
No shit! It's a fucking house!
Odin's daughter Edie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore on their new home, Orcas Island.
Hold on. Wait, how the fuck do you even lift a, like, in that time period? How would you raise it? I don't give a shit, fuck it.
Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery.
Dumbass.
His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house.
He's handy. He gets shit done. Dude, look. Oh, I can't go back. Whatever, fuck it, I don't give a shit. He even had his own hard hat already. And suspenders and shit.
Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Mysterious deaths thereafter. Oh, it's by Odin Finch. Motherfucker. Is that his cavalry sword when he fought in the French fucking war? What are the Norwegian whatever? The buttfuck wars of 1805? Oh, she had a vape? Or a mod? No, it's perfume. She did like to take those. She liked to take those painkillers, man. Look at that. She had one for every day. Getting high off that oxygen, too. That's actually cool. I like that. It's like a fake portrait where the birds fly off. Oh, and they're finches. That's cool. Wait. Oh, and it's of the house. That's really cool. They're fucking artistic, that's for sure.
Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious.
You'll find out later why. Oh, we got the yes.
I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity.
Okay, so the island in general, it has a whole town and other shit like that. That's where they got the Chinese takeout. Dude, man, these fucking Asians, you know? They'll set up shop wherever.
When Edie told people Sven was killed by a dragon, she could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
Yeah. His hard cat had kept in pristine order. Oh, and that's where the chisels come in. Okay, that makes sense. He's woodworking. I guess I should have known that. He's got a little gnome from the dwarfs. He's a carpenter. A level. He even decorated his house with levels and shit. Oh, and the baby's all shiny like it just came out brand new.
Even in her 90s, sometimes Edie seemed a lot younger than my mother.
I don't know about that. Well, maybe. Now I look at this terrible fucking bathroom. Oh no. Oh no. Oh. This is it. This is the bathroom. We'll find out about this place later. That's sad. And she had a bottle of wine. She was getting fucked up.
The only trace Grandpa Sam's first wife, Kay, left on the house was the pink bathroom. It was a pretty big trace.
Yeah, I could imagine. She was on all kinds of shit, man. I haven't seen pill bottles that fucking huge. She's getting fucked up. Hold on. Oh no, it doesn't show reflection. I know what Edith looks like. Our Edith. She's like 17. She's right there at the top. But does this key work on all of them? I guess it does. It just opens every secret passageway. You didn't get a new key at this point. Yeah, I know. There's a secret in the bathroom by the...
There's a secret Finch. In this bathroom.
Oh, and that's the dad.
It's in the last place you would look. It isn't in the cupboard. It's hidden in this book.
That's pretty cool. I want to have locks like that in my house. If I ever own a fucking house in this economy. Oh. Someone's...
Sven gave Sam an old camera he'd refurbished. He never put it down.
Oh, hey. Isn't that her mom? Where do you get those are toys. I was like, where do you get pictures of astronauts from? There's a deer. Oh, dear. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Interesting. So what, whenever they need to use this shit, they would just crawl around and stuff? That's it. And there's a beer down here. That's it. There's a beer and some... Whatever. Fuck it, I don't even give a shit no more. This family's all kinds of fucked up. Everyone's getting fucking drunk. No wonder. An art family? For sure. Obviously, that makes sense. A fucked up family? For sure, that makes sense. It's all just getting fucking wasted. Speaking of which... Play the theme music. Delicious. Where was I? Oh yeah. Dude, I'd go fucking crazy if I had to live in the same, like, there's not even enough space for this brother to live in, dude. Oh, he was a Marine. Dope. I respect that. I respect that. He's into photography. He's into shooting stuff. With a camera. Or with a gun. You know, say some mean Mother Hubbard. Oh, he's got some beers that aren't even opened. Some mean Mother Hubbard, you know, tries to tear you a structurally superfluous new behind. You know, how do you stop him? Use a gun. If that doesn't work, oh, that's sad. Use more gun.
I knew Grandpa Sam had a twin. And that he never talked about him.
Somebody dusting this place? I guess it doesn't matter. Oh, he put one of the beers in the robot's hand. That's fucked up. Like, he reached across his brother's, his dead brother's, little kid fucking brother's, like, memorialized shrine with, like, a rope. And he put a beer in the robot's hand. Oh, shit. Okay, I can go that way. Hold on. We're supposed to go up this way. To command center. He's in the space. He's really in the space. He's so in the space.
I guess my grandpa didn't like history any more than my mom did.
So in the space, he decided to go into space by dying. That's cool. I dig this. Oh, he's got a laser gun. Oh, he's got pedals! Even the spaceships don't use pedals. What you got?
How I Want to Remember My Brother by Sam Finch. The thing I remember is that when he made up his mind, that was it.
Both.
My brother said he'd die before he ate another mushroom. And he did. At Barbara's funeral, we swore we'd never be afraid again. And he wasn't. I think Calvin always wanted to fly.
Yeah, if he wanted to fly, he should have kept eating mushrooms, but he decided not to.
Calvin! Dinner's ready!
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, the dinner's coming, yeah.
But that day, he finally made up his mind to do it. I told him going around was impossible. Maybe if I hadn't said that.
Great idea is putting the swing right next to a fucking cliff.
Maybe if the wind hadn't picked up.
Like, he's already got a fucking cast from when he fell before.
Then maybe he'd still be here. But I doubt it. I think he'd already made up his mind. That's what I want to remember about my brother. The day he made it was 94. He did.
Dumbass.
Calvin's story felt strangely familiar. When I was younger, I remember trying to do the exact same thing.
Well, Edith is good at drawing, I'll say that shit.
After the funeral, Edie roped off Calvin's half of the room.
How are you gonna get to be, like, almost an adult? You know, living in this? That's not even a room, dude.
Mom said Grandpa Sam enlisted at 18 and never set foot in the room again.
Yeah, I wouldn't fucking imagine. You're gonna be like, you can bring a chick home to this? Or sneak one home? So he's got his own little fucking... Dude, like, he's smoking, drinking. What was this? Oh, this is. Oh, that's for his photos, to grab them without, like, ruining them. Apparently he played football. Still, yeah, that's no space. No fucking space whatsoever. It's ridiculous. You can't even get to half of those drawers. It's fucked up. Papillon. Their grandfather was a master carpenter, dude. This guy.
The passages were a pretty tight fit.
Yeah, because
they'd obviously been built for smaller hands and bellies.
Wait. A Viking's belly? That's cute. And more people getting drunk over here. Wait, so they could have snuck into the sister's room?
Growing up, I always thought of Barbara as a child star.
Seems like a lack of foresight. That's what I should say. Bigfoot. Like, she's got an action figure of herself? That's cool. I want an action figure of myself. It's got kung fu fart, you know, action. It's got beer drinking kung fu grip.
I never thought about how hard it must have been for her afterwards.
Oh yeah, I was talking about that in the last Final Fantasy episode, where I was like, I think child star is actually a form of child abuse, because you're setting them up for failure. Unless they continue and do good. At least the cake's all fucked up. Oh, and she smoked too. Yeah, dude, that's what I'm talking about, man. Like, you're just gonna be, I don't see any alcohol in her room, actually. The brother got fucked up all the time. Maybe there was. I don't know. I'm not looking underneath the bed. Oh, yeah, no, never mind. Hello! Oh, she didn't finish the six-pack. That's what I mean, dude. Like, that's how... Never mind. Exactly. I didn't know that was there. Barb Street. Dude, yeah. I mean, the whole family's fucked up, but straight up, dude, it's child abuse to have your kids, like, on screen. Because then they're gonna get this false expectation of what life's supposed to be. Yeah, you can drink them. Don't worry about the baby. Dumb bitch. Oh boy, comics!
Of all the stories people wrote about Barbara's death, I'm surprised Edie saved this one.
It's his guest starring.
Old Jack here with another ghastly tale inspired by America's most unfortunate family. I'm calling it The Surprise Ending of Barbara Finch. As a child star, Barbara was famous for her scream. Now at 16, she was all washed up. Has been. But in a lucky break, she'd been asked to perform her signature scream at a local convention for monster movie fans. It was just the boost her career needed.
The witch has got big tits.
Unfortunately, her scream hadn't aged well.
Getting better. I think you just need the right motivation.
She got the quarterback, apparently.
Her current boyfriend, Rick, was about to demonstrate when...
Now that was a great scream.
It was Barbara's father, Sven. He'd slipped into a table saw and had to be rushed to the emergency room.
Guess he wasn't that great.
Barbara got stuck babysitting her youngest brother, Walter. Her convention comeback was cancelled.
Okay, I'm hearing frustration, but I'm not hearing terror. What if I tried...
A gang of hoodlums in Halloween masks have been terrorizing Orca's Island tonight. Police are urging residents to...
That came from the basement.
You're right! Also, I loved your delivery on that. Why is your basement door locked?
Because my dad likes making puzzles and secret passages. There's a key hidden in the music box. The secret is to keep winding and winding until finally the key pops out.
Thanks, babe. I'll be back in a sec.
20 minutes later, Rick hadn't returned. So Barbara went to look for him, right on cue. She reached for the music box.
Oh, this is where I play.
And as she wound the key, she listened for Rick, but the house was silent. She found Rick's crutch and imagined the worst.
Yeah, dude, and everyone's getting drunk off here. Hold on, sorry. I have to do this, by the way. This is for a Steam achievement. I have to clear this table. Oh, I got it. Cool beans. And fuck out of the way.
Leader is the infamous Hookman killer, Dr. Carl Hamill, who impaled and then ate his family 10 years ago tonight. Oh dear, I don't like your delivery, ma'am. Yeah, I'm in the fucking dome.
Rick?
Barb, relax. I was just trying to scare you to help you find your scream.
Well, I'm not scared, Rick. I'm furious.
Then act furious. All I'm getting from you now is that you're hurt and confused and you're...
She threw him out, but she kept a little something to remember him by.
Barb, have you seen my other crutch?
And she was still holding it when she fell asleep watching the Late Late Picture Show. Hours later...
Barbara! Walter, what's going on up there? Okay, I'm coming up, but if this is a trick, you're dead, Walter.
All right, so here's another contention where people are like, how did she specifically die? The fuck? Oh, they're one of those 70s hanging couches. Oh, and a Tiffany lamp. They're really tacky, but I kind of want them. So, like, if you look right here, I believe there's, like, a... Maybe you see... Yeah. So you see one skate, and there's a skate by there. So I think what happened is that she fell through the railing. You'll see later it's broken. You might have noticed it earlier.
Walter, are you there?
Walter. Oh, and he really likes trains.
But his bedside radio was still on.
Orcas Island police described the man as 6 feet tall, with a steel hook for a hand. Residents are urged to lock all doors and windows and notify the police of any suspicious activity.
Barbara turned, saw the hookman, and was speechless. He was quite smashing.
Oh,
couldn't get enough of Barbara.
Okay, Barbara, there's gotta be another way out of here.
Yeah. That's cute. Leave a wobble, and they don't fall out.
That night, she played her part beautifully.
So apparently they used to just leave that shit open all the time.
Molly's door open all the years. The hinges grow. He wasn't moving, but she sensed the story might not be over yet.
Yeah, so the magazine, or the comic book, tells that, he fell? But I'm guessing that's actually how Molly died?
The hook man had vanished. She listened for his breathing, but all she heard was... from inside the house.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
Surprise!
Bravo, Barbara!
You were wonderful!
The monsters had come to surprise her. For Barbara, it was a dream come true. Then she saw what kind of monsters they were, and she realized what was about to happen. She was going to be famous. And with her final breath, Barbara Finch gave the performance of her life. I wasn't there myself, but I hear Barbara was magnificent. Poor girl. She had a taste for stardom. But unfortunately, so did her fans. Of course, the police blamed it all on poor Rick, who disappeared the same night. And little Walter? Hiding under his bed the whole time. He took it all pretty hard. But that's another story. As for Barbara, tucked inside the music box is all they ever found of her. Her ear.
Oh, maybe not. Maybe
now
the boyfriend
what
did kill her.
A real eerie tale.
Maybe the boyfriend killed her and then, like, fucking
amen. Edie told me all Barbara wanted was to be remembered, as absurd as that comic was. Maybe what Edie saw was a happy ending.
Yeah. Fuck that. Fuck that. Small bullshit. Alright. Well. Yeah. Drink another one. And she could pretend to play guitar.
I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box.
Because the key would come out. Yeah, see, it's still fucked up at this point. Did the dad die? I think he might have been... No, because he wouldn't have been dead, because the daughter died first. Because they hadn't made the fucking slide yet. So why didn't he just fix it normal style? He's a carpenter. He made all this fucking Magic Madoo, like, secret entrances into every fucking place. But no, he couldn't fix a normal fucking this railing. Whatever. Maybe it was just too easy. He didn't give a shit. I was like, oh, I'm not gonna fix that. There's no secret passages. Why the fuck would I make anything without a secret passage? That's stupid. It's dumb. Whatever. This plays surprisingly well. Hold on. No. It plays surprisingly well with the Xbox controls. Cool beans. What is this? Is that a whetstone? All battery. Okay. Backing up downstairs is always a good idea. You should do it in real life. I guess the boyfriend must have killed her, I don't know. I figured she fell down the stairs and they made a fucking story about it, but if the dude was never... I don't know, it's a fucking comic book. It's like, I mean, obviously the monsters didn't fucking fight her. You know what I mean? So, what have you. Whatever.
Mom said the basement was off limits. Unless I wanted another tetanus shot.
Oh, and he made a little model of it before he actually built it. I mean, that's cool, though. I wish I had a grandfather. I mean, not one that was, like, retarded, that made it a faulty slide, but one that was, like...
I saw Edie sneak down to the basement once, carrying packages.
Like, it'd be cool to have a grandfather that wasn't retarded, that didn't make a fucked up slide. Punching bag no one's gonna use ever.
I thought maybe she was hiding presents. It turned out she was hiding a lot more than that.
Ah, rapture. This is the can?
I remember asking Mom once about where Walter had gone. She said after Barbara died, he got as far away as he could.
Yeah. Alvino cereal. Extra crispy. He's giving the thumbs up. Yeah, this is some good shit right here, man. It's A-okay. Pea soup.
If there's a pattern in all these stories.
Jelly farms. Peanut butter. Oh, they're preserves. Never mind. Tasty beans? Oh man, all the food. All the food that's not that great. I still like them, but I know it's not that great.
I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Shaving cream. A microwave. Oh, he's got extras. And he did his own dishes. Is this a shower? It is a shower where he takes a shit and washes his dishes. Gross. Oh, he's got one of those like airline toilets where you hit the top to like flush it. And he liked trains. He really liked trains. It's kind of fucked up. You'll find out in a second. Of all the places he'll never go. Son of a bitch. This crappy fucking radio and stuff. Our exercise bike. Why do you need a bell on an exercise bike? Or I guess it shows you progress or something. Oh, hey, look at this. Just what I expected. Jack and shit. Those might be fake flowers, I'm guessing. Maybe it's a fake plant? I don't know. How are they staying alive? Who's doing this shit? Who's watering these? And he slept on a couch. What an asshole. Let's see, his last... He's alive till 2005. Oh yeah, he was. He was. This poor bastard.
Goodbye, everyone. I can't believe I've been down here for 30 years. On that first day, after the shaking started, I didn't think I'd survive the week.
Oh, and he gets more shit at the top. 1968.
But after a few days, I settled into a routine. That's what kept me sane. Having a schedule, living for today. I always expected to be dead tomorrow. But if you wait long enough, you'd be used to anything.
I'm guessing he liked cooking too. Poor bastard. I like cooking, I still like canned food.
Even a monster on the other side of the door starts to feel normal. Almost friendly. And then one day, everything just stopped. Whatever that thing was, it was gone. Maybe it got tired of waiting. Or maybe I just got tired of being afraid. It's been a week now, the longest in 30 years. I'm done waiting.
Oh, he kept.
I have to leave, while I still can.
He kept the crutch. The crutch that he framed it. Dude, this family is super fucked up. Oh, his bed, he uses the bunk bed that. They brought it downstairs. Huh. That's kind of fucked up. Hold on, I want to see how far. I bet you the chair stops me. Oh no. Well, that would have stopped me if I found a way around it, I guess. Okay, let's do it. Hold on. I like how they made a player model for everyone. You know what I mean? Like, the full player model so you can look down and see what yourself is. It's Alvin O's cereal, and it's extra crispy. Cracking the curse. Spiritual warfare, homemade weaponry, exorcism, warding away spirits. Oh my god, these guys were fucked up. The Finch curse. Bro, dude, these guys were obsessed with trying to not... Barbara Finch's child star. Jesus, man, Jesus.
I know it's out there, somewhere.
No, that's what I mean, like, it's like, dude, this is how, like, ideologies could fuck you over. It's almost actualized in a playable form.
Whatever killed Barbara. And Molly.
It's got those sweetie crisps. Just so great. A sweet way to start the morning. Sweet. Peanut butter. And he just threw his shit in a fucking
and
pot.
And Calvin.
Oh, fuck. Pea soup. Tasty beans. I'm guessing that's rice. Brown rice, you fucking asshole.
Maybe this is all a mistake. But I need to stop living the same day even if it kills me.
It took me 30 fucking years to do that.
Whatever's out there, I want you to know, I'm ready for it. I'm going to appreciate all of it, especially the food.
Right. Is he able to can food?
I don't mind if I only have a year left. Or a month. Or a single week. I'd be happy with one real day. I can already imagine the sun on my face.
Walter died when I was 6. I can't believe my mom never told me he was down here.
Well, he didn't sound like it. However old this motherfucker is. Not doing the math.
I'm sure my mom was trying to protect me.
Well, he really liked trains. Boy, they got Alvin's Crispy O's down here. They're extra crispy. Wait, they put more books? I don't think there's this many books when that dude was down here. He came down earlier?
Maybe she was afraid I'd end up like Walter.
Is it? Were they down here? I don't know. They have a lot of same copies of the same fucking books, though. Alvin's O's. Extra crispy.
But if she never told me about an uncle under the house...
Probably smells
I can like only imagine what else she was hiding.
Probably smells like shit down here, dude. Yo, straight up.
I don't want to make the same mistakes she made.
Right. Dude, this... there's flies. Smells like rancid shit. For 30 years, how... If this is his trash pile... I don't understand. Like, that's not 30 years of trash. That's like... I don't know. If you're eating that shit every day, it's like a year. That's the pile's different all of a sudden. It's fine. Whatever. So the rest of the family ate some?
Trying to bury something that's still alive. Now that there's only one of us left, or maybe two, I thought it was time I heard the stories for myself and found out what happened to everyone else. But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem.
Right? He was trying to exorcise spirits and shit with his library? So I'm talking about ideologies, you know? It's like you get fucked up in the head, you get...
Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real.
Right? Motherfuckers. Yeah, let's put a fucking train memorial next to where our fucking family member died from a fucking train. Also, in Walter's room, there was a train that was underwater. So, before this shit collapsed, that's why I was looking at it earlier, and I was like, oh. Fucked up.
I don't know if I should even be writing this.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm gonna pause it right here. This will be the end of episode 1 of Edith Finch. It's probably gonna be a 2-part because it's a short game. I figured. I was just gonna do it by beer, but it's not gonna cut properly. So I'll just make this like 2 big parts. It's not a long game. The next one's probably gonna be a lot shorter. Anyways, thanks for watching.